Since the advent of the Alleyne School, we have been inundated with many individuals who have lived up to the motto, at least one city for others, not self. One such individual is our guest speaker for today, Mr. Henderson, Wiltshire. Born before the turn of this century, but very much with the current times, Mr. Wiltshire has matured into a man that has pursued many aspects of education and of certification. His secondary education took place on this very compound, where he was a prefect, deputy head boy, and a cadet sergeant major. He continued his studies at the Barbados Community College, receiving a Bachelor of Education in Technical and Vocational Education. This was followed by a Master's of Science in the area of Human Resource Management and a Certificate in Educational Leadership, both of which were obtained from the University of the West Indies. Mr. Wiltshire also holds a Technical Teacher Certificate from Burdiston Teachers Training College and a Certificate in Education Excellence in Public Schools obtained from the Civil Service College in Singapore. Having gained extensive training in education, he has put it to good use by becoming a teacher and has influenced students at the St. John's Senior School during 1985 to 1986 and St. Lucie Secondary School, now known as the Dower Jordan Secondary School, for 25 years from 1986 to 2011. During his work experience, he has also undertaken developmental training to assist with his chosen career. These include the Caribbean and national vocational qualifications in master training and external and internal verification, all obtained from the TPEC Council here in Barbados. He has also traveled to Jamaica and now holds the Caribbean and national vocational qualifications in level 4 assessment and facilities auditing. He currently holds the position of Education Officer in the Ministry of Education, Science, Technology and Innovation and has held this post for the last 5 years. Not forgetting from whence he came, Mr. Wiltshire is the Ministry's representative on the Board of Management here at the Alleyne School, and he also loans his experience and knowledge to the Alexandra School in the same role. He has represented the Ministry on various committees, including the Caribbean Vocational Qualification, CVQ, implementation, and the National Qualification Framework. His profession has also afforded him the opportunity to represent the Ministry of Education at various conferences and training programs, locally, regionally, and internationally. Despite what seems to be a rather hectic schedule, Henderson Wiltshire has outlined his interests as fishing and hiking. When asked if he's ever caught anything, he replied, "Of course, horse eyes, which he said are the best tasting fish that you'll ever have, and snappers among many others." He is a Seventh-day Adventist every day and believes in the role of the family in church and society, and as a result is married to the lovely Heather Wiltshire, who is also a teacher by profession. Next Wednesday, they'll be celebrating 20 years of marriage. The reunion has produced a beautiful daughter, Michaela, and a handsome son, Nishan. This gentleman also has a passion, and he is known for saying what this passion is, and I quote for you: "I am passionate about seeing young students succeed and reach their full potential. I have a special interest in students of newer secondary schools where society and systems see them as failures. Hence, most of my working life was spent at one of these schools. I am privileged to be a part of the Caribbean Vocational Qualification Initiative, where a number of students in newer secondary schools and other grammar schools have been certified and gained employment or even started their own businesses." Having heard all of these accolades and about the passion of Mr. Wiltshire, one can see why he has been chosen to address us today, given our theme. Thus, without any further ado, please join me in welcoming to the podium our featured speaker, Mr. Henderson Wiltshire.
reach the more meaning. And as for a root name, I'm sure all of you regret, but the organization is correct. Thank you very much.
We can dream because there is where it all begins, with a step, knowing we can do it. See the light, it's time to realize our potential to grow, to be whatever we dream. Focus on our goals, to be the winners, with science and technology, together we can go far. Resource Development Program for Barbados, realizing human potential.
Thank you, Master Chairman, for your kind words and discussion as well. The Chairman of the Board of Management of the Alleyne School's Reverend, Carseen Ramsey, Deputy Chair, Mr. Don Foster, and other members of the Board of Management of Alleyne School, Principal of Alleyne School, Ms. Julia Deppard, and other principals, Deputy Principal, Mr. Paul Phillips, and other members of the staff of Alleyne School. Past principal of the Alleyne School, my own principal, Mr. Jordan, and the deputy principal, Mr. Douglas, members of the Alleyne family, president of PTA, Mr. David Henry, other members of the PTA executive, president of praises, Mr. Kevin Wiltshire, and Mr. Buck, parents, awardees, students, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, a very pleasant good morning to all. Let's try again, Ms. Backers. A very pleasant welcome and good morning to all. Thank you very much. Now, it is indeed a pleasure and an honor to deliver the future address and face to share. I'm really so a bit nervous. I always made a lot of speeches and so forth, but it's especially different and unique when you do it at your own matter. Now, when Mr. Trotter contacted me to be the new speaker, I actually thought he had the wrong number. So the phone went quiet for a little while. He said, "You're a great person." So I want to thank the principal, staff, the speech committee for entrusting me with the task of addressing you on this speech day. Now, speech days, by design, are usually a long process, one that cannot be avoided. I therefore will try to be as tempting as possible. In other words, I will not speak for very long. But the theme chosen for this occasion, celebrating entrepreneurship, creating a vision for our skills and talents, is one that is very timely and critical at this stage of the existence of Barbados. I'm not sure of the rationale for writing on this topic, but it is a very important topic. Entrepreneurship, especially in Barbados, is worthy of celebration and has been discussed at different levels and forums during the year. Approximately 5 years ago, Barbados embarked on an initiative to assist the development of the Barbadian workforce. Those who are employed, those who are employers, and those who are basically working for themselves. This led to the development of the policy document, a document called the Barbados Human Resource Development Strategy 2011-2016. I feel everyone of all citizens of Barbados should have a look at this document to see what would have been done over those 5 years and what we intend to do, or what is intended rather, for Barbados in the future. And it's entitled Institutional and human capacity for sustainable growth. The mission of this strategy is to develop national, institutional and human capacity so that the potential of all Barbadians is fully realized. Now, this strategy is built upon 5 pillars, which include one, I want to call it one, enabling environment, from two, national qualification framework, to the three, demand-driven education system, to the four, knowledge management systems, and to the five, research, innovation, and entrepreneurship. And that is to the five. And this pillar fits well in the theme for today's event. In this pillar, the government of Barbados has recognized the importance of investment in research, innovation, and entrepreneurship has provided a competitive advantage in an increasingly global economy. For the full potential of research, innovation, and entrepreneurship to be realized, it is important to build the human capacity through skills and for processes that support this culture. The strategy addresses these elements. However, before we begin to discuss the notion of entrepreneurship and explore the creation of a vision linked to skills and talents, I would think we first have to establish two things or foundations. We first have to apply the term entrepreneurship, and secondly, put this term into context. Now, let me examine the term entrepreneurship. Our main journey falls on a person opening a business. However, entrepreneurship has a far more deeper meaning. It's more or less owning the business or working for yourself. Now, Peter Drucker, a well-known and renowned educator and author, defined an entrepreneur as someone who actually searches for change, responds to it, and exploits change as an opportunity for success. He suggests that entrepreneurship essentially do not just do something better, but they do it differently. He also linked innovation and entrepreneurship and proposed that the practice of innovation is a specific tool of entrepreneurship, the means by which entrepreneurs exploit change as an opportunity for a different business or a different service. John Hayward III, however, suggests that maybe we need to expand what entrepreneurship means. He boldly posited that a more useful definition might be an entrepreneur may be someone who sees an opportunity to create value and is willing to take a risk to capitalize on that opportunity. Now, as we seek to celebrate entrepreneurship, we have to understand a little of our history as we use this term, black people. And I don't think we should refer to that term. As we have struggled over the years with this whole concept of entrepreneurship. Now, for example, my grandfather, I was born in 1912. And by the age of 14, him and many others had to finish school. And this was an effort to keep them uneducated for one, and to ensure they continue to work for someone, especially if their parents were unable to pay for further education. The efforts were made by various volunteers, if we were paying attention on some of the workflows that we realized, to hinder that person from having their own meetings. And those who had were forced out of business. In Bristol, for example, most of those businesses in early years were not only were owned by black persons. And this is 17 that I made reference to earlier. However, even though there were external challenges to black businesses in the system, there has been great success. Persons have fought to keep their businesses alive and have been successful at doing that. One of the ways to which these persons have advanced their businesses was through education. That's why a high value which is based on education and the opportunity to educate should not be wasted. And also, this is why it hurts to see so many students waste time at school. They place no value on education and the tools that they can go with. Now, as we celebrate entrepreneurship, we ought to understand the fight and sacrifices made by these persons in Barbados. And as we celebrate entrepreneurship, and explore the vision of skills and talents, it is important that we support each other. In other words, as entrepreneurs, those who choose to apply to entrepreneurs or those who are entrepreneurs as well, should purchase raw materials from each other, should sell to each other, and create linkages with each other. A black person or all black persons, all Barbados should work together. Now, developing competencies in terms of skills does not go alone. There are two other concepts that we have to add to that. Growth of knowledge and attitude. So we refer to them in the realm of teacher qualification as competencies. Then we have your knowledge, skills, and attitudes. And these are critical to entrepreneurship. It is important to stress that we live in a dynamic world. And hence, skills and network expertise, which are relevant today, may not be relevant tomorrow. Therefore, sustainable success requires a mindset of continuous learning. You are never too old to learn. The skills that are needed for today's workforce will not be required for the future, and that has been proven. The world that we learn today will research for a question, putting on persons for a question for what they think the next 50 years in Barbados would lay, and purchase more of sports of technology and other advances. However, very one student normally asked about school, how would she see school in the next 50 years? She said, school? What school? In 50 years, there will be no school. Her concept is that I know such children die for that day. However, her concept is in that the next 50 years, persons will not gather in a building like this. They will be at home, teachers will be here, or somewhere and communicate with students, and that's one of what we call virtual learning. So she doesn't envision that there will be schools for the next 50 years, which is a great or not good option. Now, it would is increasingly shaped by exponential changes in technology. New opportunities are arising at an ever more rapid rate. Entrepreneurs must be willing and able to take these risks and the season and harness the opportunities on the other side. Now, there's a woman who watched television and movies. You would have called them science fiction. And basic fiction means something as false, or as a false. Now, you would watch television and watch movies such as Star Wars and Elysium and Big Brother, and you will see cars flying. Now, what do you say if I told you that you always have, you don't have cars that fly? What do you say? What do you say? Pardon me? Sounds impossible? Right, actually, two countries now have cars that fly. The Dutch, for the last 8 years, have developed a car that flies. And now, the American, they have also developed a car that flies. And maybe for the front cities on television, we say coming, that will never happen. Now, the point of it, as we said, where we said this. Now, these cars are being sold in America. Sorry, they have one in America that's gone for 8 years. And it has gone up 1,400 feet. These cars will retail at $270,000. And so far, 100 persons have already deposited $10,000 each to the company to own one of these cars. Now, that has been mentioned to state that as young entrepreneurs, there is a deep of vision of skills and talents. If you can dream it, you can develop it. I believe your people are living, as you mentioned before, in a very special time. And these are opportunities that are there, and the ones that are trained in a wide range of areas and develop skills, then they can look into areas that they think are impossible. But I know at the school there is a rich study program and these programs and these areas that they brought to initiatives such as that. Now, the opportunity for young persons are based through self-employment and endless, especially as I mentioned before in areas of ICT. We have already developed cell phones, but in terms of innovation, we can learn to build on the cell phone industry. Now, Carseen has already had also added gaming and animation to its curriculum. And that's another area that has been taken off rapidly, and again, I see for the backdrop money as a foundation. So, these are areas that persons can get into and actually make money. And of course, you don't have to be able to bless school to get into these areas. Entrepreneurship can begin while you're at school. For example, my son, you don't want to say that, but for the last probably 5-6 years, he has been in agriculture. So, he plants his own forest, the ground itself, plants his own stuff, he sells it. But of course, he has a real problem. I also plant potatoes. So, very often you won't ask me, but I don't know if it's a good sell, but I don't even touch one. You want to sell everything. And of course, many people are repaid, and if they want to also use it, tell me, that will sell it at our price. But I'm saying that, our project can begin at any age.
From the farm, get the home, link up the family and come, let it go.
Roll, bang, eat, bang, live, bang, right here in bed.
Yes!
Roll, bang, eat, bang, live, bang, right here in bed.
No, we don't have to buy all imported stock, cause high nutrition in the food that we got. Plant something, start your own crop, grow something, more cause the pot in your pot. It's true, more healthy with the fresh produce, with high nutritional value. It costs less to grow and eat your own food, so gather the crew, come!
Roll, bang, eat, bang, live, bang, right here in bed.
Yes!
Roll, bang, eat, bang, live, bang, right here in bed.
change has created the need for a new and specific measure of cost in this group and our business from section. New, what we call green occupations, have emerged into the market for sectors that may have only not be directly linked to environmental issues. But this shift has led to creation of new employment opportunities in manufacturing, construction, and transportation, while at the same time creating and expanding an opportunity and niches. Technological changes and innovation are important for new skill demands. Currently, many of the new innovations include areas such as solar panels, and will also improve agribusiness, biotechnology, food technologies, production design, and resource management. And these are areas that personally get into now as entrepreneurs. Now, there's another area that I want to address for attention to in my answer of it. This is something called 3D printing. Now, you know, Barbados, we have a high degree of amputations, right? Now, I was speaking a couple of weeks ago to Alleynian, and we are working on this project. Now, 3D printing is new. But we were just discussing, we were saying that, you know, we have a lot of persons who are amputated in Barbados yearly. But we don't have to build buses anymore. We can print it. So there's technology which suggests that even in that area, which is really the niche market, unfortunately, that even as something that's important, yes, as the processes can be printed, no longer do you have to go to the lab and or workshop and build one or make one. And in my capacity as a basic education, we are responsible for solutions. I'm exploring that possibility in terms of one school or two schools. I see Mr. Mayor, the audience, the one who will this one. Where we can offer a certificate in 3D printing, or some aspect of 3D printing as a certificate. All that we require is collaboration with the Council in the development of standards and links, and then we can see what happens from there. But in the time of the Barbados from who has a lot of positive experience and knowledge in this area, so we are trying to work on something to see how best we can get that. Skill in school, and I think that will be quite important. So, as we celebrate entrepreneurship, creating a vision for skills and talent, we also have to pay attention to another part of the competency, the area of attitude. And this is reflected in soft skills, which is mentioned, which is how we interact with your customers and so forth. Now, as mentioned in the brief bio, I have had the opportunity or the privilege to travel through many parts of the various parts of the world. And one of my most unique visits was to Singapore. It's better than a Texas system. And I have never seen customer service at such a high level. It's as if these persons are robots. They all treat similarly, but you never get a bad attitude or something negative from any of them in any store or any other group or going on. But I have seen a little improvement in customer service in my business, which is good. But I learned from the IABB, I learned by the name of Dr. Mariana Alfonso. She's seen specialists in the Indian American Development Bank. And in 2012, she did a survey in Barbados. And she said that most Barbadian workers that have been working with someone or self-employed, they lack these skills. And she went on to say that the ability to work with people, the ability to lead, to take curriculum, to respect authority, to function, to work, and to be on time for meetings, is starting lacking in our work skill. But I've seen some improvement in terms of our customer service, and maybe she may have been correct in what she could have found, but in some instances, there is some room for improvement, but if you're working towards getting that part of our culture correctly. Now, schools have a great part to play in this, in terms of encouraging entrepreneurship, which ensures students have the requisite knowledge, skills, and attitude. And this can be done, I saw the role again on the table, during basic speed. Now, turning basic speed is usually the most reserved for a person to do IT, business, and so forth. But maybe we can experience this concept of basic speed to persons who are not actually in business classes. Now, we had a presentation at Prince Mara a couple of weeks ago, which tools to see this includes a number of areas, from St. Mary's, Alleyne, and so forth. And now these persons are looking to go into the world of business, and in terms of that's where we need to go. So I'm saying that persons who are not in business, their business departments in school can be looked after during the speed. In terms of the ability to develop skills for self-employment, operate business plans, and so forth. And that is that will help in terms of assisting them as they leave school into going into the world of work in terms of their own business. And CSC also has seen this as part of their vision in terms of developing a daily person, secondary now in terms of CSEC program and SDA, so you don't have to write a business plan. And that's part of their requirements. So they're looking to encourage students to actually go into self-employment. Now, in the article I found, in doing a little bit of research, one writer indicated that there are possibly four basic skills that you need to be committed to the threat of entrepreneurship. These would be personal characteristics, and we need to have vision. In the personal skills, we need to be able to lead, critical and creativity, think, in terms of problem solving, and practice, and goal setting, and social media. And there are five skills that also go over that. These include the ability to develop a compelling vision, that we're talking in terms of a vision for skills and talent. You have the talent, you have the skills, but make sure your vision is compelling. The ability to clearly recognize your company's strengths and weaknesses. So when you open your business, you have the ability to recognize your company's strengths and weaknesses. You must have the ability to get more people for on the bus. By that, I mean that smart leaders must recognize that they are alone and can't solve all of those problems. And you have to be on persons who are able to help them to solve problems in the business. And the ability to adapt based on feedback. Most of us as people don't like to hear feedback, especially if it's critical, but that's something that we need to adopt if we're going to the world self-employment. And then the ability to execute. You have to execute your own business. So as I conclude this address, I just want to ensure that you were very leading in the at least not the ideas are very come from in terms of entrepreneurship and where we are to go. Now as we examine that, we will examine the leading celebrate entrepreneurship, bring your vision for skills and talents. We have just celebrated 50 years of existence as an independent nation. And part of this was built on entrepreneurship. And this is a big initiative. So as we go forward, let me have to endeavor to keep this culture alive for the next 50 years, where skills and talents can be utilized. And as for those persons or children who are here for thinking of embarking on entrepreneurship, there is opportunity for lots of productive money and aim, but it calls for hard work and dedication. And you need to put that into practice, even though we have the skills and vision. So, to those, I just want to first of all congratulate those awardees who are receiving prizes today, and your hard work has paid off. And do hope that you see this stepping forward to entrepreneurship or into the world of work, and that the values, the skills, and knowledge our parents here at the school will be used to develop yourself and to help to develop our national values. Ladies and gentlemen, students, I want to thank you for your being here, and we hope you enjoy the rest of this morning's proceedings. Thank you very much.